Welcome, friends, to week number 7 of the Muskrat Link Sim Tour, where we battle against the best golfers in the world for cash, titles, and most importantly, points to secure our place on tour. Be sure you are subscribed to support this exclusive content. Let's head over to the first tee at Whistling Straits.
Now for our 3:15 tee time, tied for 47th at 2 over par, Kyler Gauthier.
Thank you. Thanks, everybody. Let's have a good one today. Bunker's not going to cause us too much trouble. We should be able to approach this green. Can we hit the green with this approach? Let's give it a go. Boom, what a bunker shot. Let's go. Birdie look. Only one birdie on day one. Can we get him to fall on day two? She's heading down there. Turn, baby, turn. Oh, just missed. We'll take a tap in par. 562-yard par 5. Let's take advantage and get a birdie. What a great shot. Get down there, right down the pipe. 282. Let's see if we can get something down by the green. That'll put us in good shape to approach this green. 52 yards left. Let's see if we can stick this tight and tap in for bird. Settle. That's not good. Crushed it. Need a little up and down now to escape here with a par. Get up. Oh man, what a stinker. All right, let's recover and get this one close. Turn! Oh, that's going to be a long putt for bogey. We need to get this a drop, but this putt looks tough. Come on, baby, hit the cup. Oh, what a bogey save. All right, we are still in this. 175, par 3, a little bit downhill, pin in the back. Oh, we're going to bounce down into the bunker. All right, 18 yards back up a cliff face to get up onto this green. Get up, baby. Oh, almost jarred it. We'll take a putt for par. Get in the hole, baby. Get in the hole. Yes, sir. Let's go. One over through three, three over for the tournament. 452-yard par 4 here. Let's rip one down the fairway. Will it turn in? Yes, sir. Lips in the back. What a par putt. Let's go. Need to hit the fairway with this drive. Let's get one out there. Oh no. Oh no. We are dead. This would be an incredible par on this hole. Come on, let us in. Let us in one time. Yes, what a par. Huge recovery. We are not dead yet. 384-yard par 4. Please, can we not scramble for once? Give us a chance, give us a chance. Hold, hold, hold. All right, we'll take that. Tap in par. 186 today, pin is up front. Let's see if we can stick one on the green. Get up there for me, one time. What a shot from 186, get in the freaking hole. 7-footer left here for birdie, we need to convert this. Roll true, roll true. Boom, right in there, back to even and 2 over on the tournament. That's how to play a par 3. Super long 474-yarder here, let's swing away. Putt for bogey, let's keep those doubles off the scorecard. Come on, get in there. Yes! All right, we are playing some bad golf, but it could be a lot worse. 415-yard par 4, let's see if we can hit a fairway. Give us a chance. Give us a chance. Oh, just up the outside. All right.
1 over on the front, 3 over for the tournament, tied for 40th. We played some really bad golf on the front, but somehow came out looking okay. 360 yards here into this par 4. I think it's about, what is it, 200-300 to that pot bunker out there. So I think we'll just aim right at it and let it fade. Faded a little too much, but we'll still find the fairway. Gonna leave us a little bit longer into this green, but hopefully we've got a good angle and we should be able to stick one close. 111 yards left in here, 10 feet uphill. Pin is tucked in the back left. We will just try to hit the center of the green with this one. Let's get a birdie look going here. Oh, that is looking good. Settle, settle, spin right there. Spin and hold. What a shot from 110. Let's go. If we want to mount a comeback, it needs to start right now. 8 feet left. Quite a bit of break in this one though. We gotta go maybe a cup outside left and then hope we hit it good. Come on, get in there. Yes, sir, that's a birdie. Bringing us back to even on the day, 2 over on the tournament.
537-yard par 5 here. Let's see if we can give this a rip. Maybe we can go for this green. Got under that one a little bit, so it's not going to go very far. Hanging on to the edge there. Get over the bunker. Not quite, but that's not a bad place to be. 266, 30 feet uphill here. This is going to be tough to get anywhere down by the green. I think I'm just going to take a 9-wood, see if maybe I can keep it in the fairway here. Coming out hot and a little bit left, but that's going to be okay. As long as we don't go up against the lip of this bunker, yeah, no worries. Let's get this next one tight. 65-yarder here. I'm not too concerned with the lip. I'm just concerned with trying to get this somewhere near the pin. It's on a ridge as well. That's an absolutely brutal pin placement. But all right, all we can do is hit the green from here. Decent out up onto the green. Maybe go left a little bit for me. We will take that. That's an approach. 14-footer for birdie here. Looks like we got some left to right at the beginning. Then it goes down and back down a hill at the end. That's going to be tough to hold it by the hole. So, all right, let's see if we can get this thing lined up and maybe give ourselves half a chance of making this one. It's up. It's on the way. I don't think it's quite got the right line. Oh, it does. It lips in the edge. Let's go. Another birdie. Back-to-back birdies to start the back nine. I didn't think that was going to come back. Just had a little bit of movement at the end. 145-yard par 3 here, downhill. Pin is again on a ridge, so if we hit the green, I will be very happy. Pulled the 9-iron, but it looks like it's the right distance, so it should hold the green here. This is going to be a tricky putt coming back up the hill, but all right, we will take that. That's not bad. We didn't end up in the water. Well, we've got 14 yards here, but got a big ridge to go up, so I'm probably going to chip this and just try to land it right at the top of this ridge. Let it kind of funnel back to the hole down to the left after it lands. See if we can get this inside of 6 feet. Settle, settle. Oof. All right, that's pretty good. It's definitely not 6 feet, but we didn't roll back down the ridge, which is what I was afraid of. So, all right, we'll take a look at par. Not a terrible look at par here. 12-foot putt, got some good right to left in this one. Just kind of have to lay it out that right side there. That actually doesn't look too bad, you know, and just hope we can find the back of the cup. Speed is good. Do we have the right line? Hold up, hold up. Not quite. Maybe I did need to hit that one a little harder, but that's a disappointing bogey from where we were, but let's make it up on the next hole. 373-yard par 4 here. Last time we hit our drive and we carried over the mountains here on the left, so let's try not to do that this time. What do we got? To the end of this bunker is about 260, so that's kind of where our marker is right now. I think we just try to hit it here, play a little fade, and see if we can get one running down there. That's looking like it's going to be A-okay. Fading down there. I caught it off the heel a little bit, so it's not going to go super far. This hole is quite a bit downhill, so we're getting some good run out on this one. That is perfect. 295 down the middle. 81 yards left here, 10 feet downhill. Pin is kind of in a nice little bowl. Oh my goodness. All I need to do is get into this bowl and we'll have a good look at birdie. This is a very generous pin. Let's see if we can get one in there. It's up. Is it going to be able to make it down into that bowl? Bounce for me. Yes, release down towards the hole. Oh, what a shot. That is what we're talking about. Inside of 6 feet. That's a birdie. Immediate bounce back. Plus one on the tournament now. We are playing some wild golf out here today. Tied for 26th now on the tournament. 381-yard par 4 up here next. What is it to this ridge? Just bump out. It's like 300 right to the top here. So all we can do is kind of hit our drive and hope for the best. Pin looking front right, so being on the left isn't the worst thing, but I'd rather be in the fairway. Pretty stock standard drive for us there. Aim left, fade to the back, gonna hit the middle of the fairway. That is beautiful and should give us a good look into this green. 88 yards left here. Pin is looking pretty friendly. We got some movement there, but I think the miss is probably a little bit to the left, so we'll aim just left of the flag and see if we can poke one down. Needs to settle. I kind of put a little bit too much juice on that one. Well, I expected better from there, but all right, let's see if we can get up and down from here. From the fringe, probably going to chip because there's a lot of movement in the middle that we do not want to deal with. Runs off the front if we go past it. I think we can kind of go right at this thing, though. We just have to get the speed right. Release. Head down there, ball. Head down there. Oh, a little short. We're going to have to putt this. This is going to be a tense putt for par. 10-footer left here, right to left as well. Not too much in it, though. I think we can aim, yeah, maybe a cup outside. That looks pretty good. All right, let's see if we can scare the hole. Is it going to be right? Needs to turn a little bit for us. Yes, in the side door. Our putter's kind of saving us today with all the disasters that we've been doing. All right, on to the next. We've got a 439-yard par 4 up here next. It is 270 to the front of this bunker, so we can technically reach it. I guess we'll just try to hit the fairway. Pin looks like it's front left as well, so if anything, we'd like to be more up the right-hand side. Playing the fade again, working out for us. Again, it was a little off the heel though, so we're gonna lose some distance, but I am not complaining about the results. That's a good drive. 161 yards left into this pin, kind of front left. Not the worst pin placement, but this is gonna be hard to get close. It's gonna be a nice full 8-iron, I think. Gave that 8-iron all I had. Is it going to be the right number? Boy, it sure looks like it is. We will take that every day of the week. That's going to be a nice clean look at birdie. Let's see if we can knock it down. 19 footer down the hill a little bit here. We got a little bit of left to right, a little bit of right to left, probably a little bit more right to left in the beginning here. So maybe just outside right edge seems good. The kick is up. It's on the way. The line's looking decent. Break right and go in. What? It's hanging on the edge. Someone wait for the wind to blow, please. 3 inches apparently. Sometimes that's all it takes. All right, on to the next. 514 yard par five up here. We would love to take advantage of this one. Again, gonna be tough to approach this green, but to the bump out here, it's about 308. So our landing zone's probably just gonna be right about here. Let's see if we can catch some more fairway. It's a pretty nice drive, dead straight. Unfortunately, that's right where I was aiming, so I think we're gonna bounce away from this bunker. Yeah, okay, that works out for us. We'll take it. 233 yards. Man, I promised I'd be more aggressive today. I think we're just gonna try to smash this straight at it, and if we fade off to the right and end up somewhere closer to the fairway, we'll take it. Let's let the four wood eat. I've given it all I can. Get up the hill forward. Make it up there for me. Not quite. We are in the bunker, but that's pretty much exactly what we expected. So now we've got a shot to see if we can hold this green. 44 yards left on the approach to this green in the bunker. Looks like it's going left to right down by the pin, so we'll aim maybe a little bit left, but all I want to do is give myself a look at birdie here. Get up and get down, maybe get in the hole. Oh, we almost hopped that thing in. What a shot out of the bunker. That's not gonna be 6 feet, but it is a nice clean look at birdie. 10 footer down the hill here for birdie. I would really like this one to go in. This would be clutch to make. See if we can make a nice strong push here at the end. I think it's just outside the hole. I like it. I like it a lot. Yes, indeed. That's a birdie. We are all over the map today. Birdies, bogeys, but it's all coming together. Back to even par on the entire tournament, and now we're tied for 18th. I don't know exactly how we're doing it, but we're playing some golf out here today. Two to go. 200 yard par three up here. Pin is tucked behind this bunker, but that's kind of okay because it plays our fade pretty nicely. I think we're just gonna hit a 5-iron and see if we can get one to cozy on back there. Trying to cozy it back there. It's looking pretty good. Give me a friendly bounce left. All right, that's okay. That's some really nice distance control. We will take that. I feel like we need a chip in now. 9 yards left here. This is prime chip in territory. Not much movement in it. We are gonna go straight at it. I want to rattle that flag stick. Come on, baby, run out. Oh, it's not quite gonna get there. I should have given it a little bit more of a run. That's okay though, that's a par. That keeps us at even. Still tied for 18th here through 17 holes. We've got one signature hole up left here. Let's see if we can make a par. The hardest hole on the course remains for us here at 439 yards. I think this time we're gonna take the driver and try to go up the left side because we have been fading it all day. I feel pretty confident in this. I'm not gonna swing hard. Let's just see if we can get something down there. Well, we sure as heck faded it. Now we just have to not bounce all the way down into the water. I think we're gonna be okay though. I was never really gonna flirt with it that much. Yeah, we'll take that. On the launch pad, that should be a good approach. 148, 9 feet downhill out of the heavy rough. Those will kind of cancel each other out. Pin is in a dangerous position again here. I think we'll go straight for it, let it fade back. I do want to kind of land left of this ridge though. I don't want to be up on that top shelf. So I think we'll go right about here with just a nice smooth 9, I think. Buttercut 8, actually. Decided to take the 8-iron instead. That was definitely a good play because 9 would have been well short. 8, it's okay. We didn't get punished that bad, but good thing I swapped clubs there. One final chance at chipping redemption. We haven't chipped in anything this tournament yet. Little bit of right to left there at the end, so we'll aim just outside the edge. 10 yards out of the heavy rough. I really want to give this one a run. Come on, baby, break. Go. Oh, just short again. All right, that is still a really good result. What a roller coaster of a day it has been. Let's sign the scorecard and head over to the media tent.
He finished at even par, two under for today. Did you think you could do that after what happened on the front nine?
The front nine was really tough. We were all over the place. I was spraying balls into the water, missing fairways by 50 yards, and we still somehow managed to stay in. I think it was probably the putter. So being able to stop what I was doing on the front, change it up completely, and do something different on the back that was actually good, that was a good feeling. I'm glad we pulled it out.
What parts of your game clicked that allowed you to make this run?
Yeah, I think we really kind of stepped up a little bit in the driver department. It wasn't an overall good driving day, but the back nine, it was great. We really kind of reined in and got that under control. Approach shots were really good too. We were starting to stick some of those irons. I did a lot more pin seeking today than I'd done on previous days. Around the green, we never really got it going. We were kind of just futzing around there. We had a few chips that just were nowhere near the hole, and the putter really got hot again for us today. I really count on the putter to make something happen, and today we made it happen.
Next week is at Atkinson Resort and Country Club. Are you feeling the pressure to perform there?
Yeah, there's definitely some pressure with that. Atkinson is a course here in my home state of New Hampshire, so it's not really a tour level course, so a lot of these guys are going to go really low at Atkinson, but that doesn't mean I have to play bad. I can go low as well there, so I'm really hoping to apply the pressure. The hometown crowd will be behind me. I'm really looking forward to next week. All right, thanks everybody. See you then.
As we check in with the Pro Tour, we reflect on a gritty performance from Kyler this week on a very tough course. Playing through some struggles, he dug deep and grinded out a respectable result. Next week's event is in his home state of New Hampshire, so the pressure is on to deliver for his hometown crowds. Can he keep his spot in the top 15? Subscribe to Muskrat Links so you don't miss a thing. See you next week!